There's a lot of people that build websites in WordPress. However, not a lot of them are proficient with writing code or interpreting code, seeing the mistakes in code and stuff like that. But sometimes you need to resort to a solution that's only available with code. So you go in there, Stack Overflow, WordPress community, whatever, you paste some code from a forum or elsewhere, and it doesn't work. There's an error. Something is just not right on your website, and you get a critical error. You cannot log back into WordPress. So what do we do? Hi, my name is Mr. Gekko, and I'm helping you create better websites. This channel is all about WordPress, Gutenberg, and the whole design process behind it. So, if you're into that, consider subscribing. So here we are on one of my test websites. So, let's say I have this ACF taxonomy shortcode. This is my custom plugin, and it has a syntax error. So, somehow it got through, and when I reload this page, I get the critical error. And when this happens, actually in the recent versions of WordPress will, if you entered the email and everything correctly as admin email, it will email you back and give you a link to actually disable your plugins or whatever caused the issue, enabling debug mode or something like that, to let you fix the error without going to the backend. But here, this thing here, whatever happened, is now a critical error. Please check your site admin email inbox for instructions. So now I can't even log back into the backend, and I need to go back to my cPanel. Like, you need a server access where your WordPress installation is located. This is cPanel. Maybe you're using Plesk or some other backend manager, or you're using FTP connection. So either way, you have to access somehow your backend and access what's causing the problem. So I know that my plugins have caused the error, but you may not know what caused the error. So you may rename the whole plugin directory to plugins 1, let's say like that, and let's check back in here. You see, now it works, but I've broken it because there's no plugins now. Let me go back inside my dashboard. Let me go to the plugins, and you see now all the plugins give me error, and there's no plugins currently available. So, but the theme is looking awkward because I'm using Cadence Theme, and Cadence Theme needs some plugins to function. So not right now, I disabled everything. So when you don't know what's causing the issue, so just disable everything. And when you want to disable everything, as you see, just rename the plugin in question, because for example here, I know that the plugin in question was ACF, so you can just rename ACF to something like ACF1, and yeah, you will return to the previous state. But now, since I renamed to plugins 1, I actually deactivated. What happened is I deactivated all of them. So then you can activate one by one and see what's causing the issue. Sometimes also you may have an issue where you want to edit your functions PHP file in your child theme or your theme, but you should always use child theme, of course. I have one of those videos up there in the cards. If you want to check why you should use child theme. But in child theme, you have this function PHP file, so you may have code here that's breaking the site as well. So renaming this functions PHP file to functions PHP 1, just rename it, you know, that WordPress doesn't recognize it's that functions PHP file, and it will render it to, you know, not usable, and it will just exclude that file from using, and then you will have your site back. So that's basically what's happening here. And there's actually one more way to fix this, even without having access to your server backend, like cPanel or FTP and things like that. So what happens is, when critical errors occur in your WordPress website, the website itself will automatically issue an email to your admin account, your admin email. and you will get a recovery link, same like you get a link when you forget password. So you click that link, you log back into the backend, it enters recovery mode, and you can fix things yourself. So if you like content like this, hit that thumbs up button. I know this video is very simple and easy and quick, but sometimes I feature code and critical errors may occur to your WordPress if you copy paste some stuff that I give you. So this is just a quick disclaimer how to fix if these things occur. So I hope you're doing well, and thanks for watching my content and supporting me. So yeah. See you in the next one.